and a very full chest, and he's a big boy. What I find really romantic is consistency.
This is interesting.
Oh no.
if you hadn't met Will, right, would you ever consider dating a fan of yours? Hello and welcome to Real English with Real Teachers. Today we've got a lovely guest. We've got Lucy from English with Lucy. Hello.
Hello. Hi. Thank you for having me. It feels like a very long time since I've been on your channel.
Oh, I know. We've been missing you.
3-4 years. We have. I know. You're too far away now.
It's true. It's true. But technology, hey, it's bringing us closer.
Definitely.
So today I thought we would give your viewers a little bit of an insight into you, Lucy, the personality behind the channel. How about that?
There isn't any. Oh. I'm just a robot.
We're done. Goodbye. Thank you very much. And subscribe.
Please subscribe and like, yeah.
No, I'm sure there is. I know there is. So we are going to go through some personal questions, quite lighthearted.
Okay.
Most of them. With some sprinkling of some interesting ones. So let's get into it.
You're watching
Real English
with
Real Teachers.
Real Teachers.
And before we get into this delightfully personal Q&A with Lucy, let me tell you about this video's sponsor that is offering you a wonderful opportunity to inject a mammoth amount of motivation into your English studies for a period of 3 months to break beyond your current level of English. And all of this can and has been rewarded with 100% cash back. It sounds too good to be true, but it's simple. If you attend all your classes in the 3 month period, you get your money back. It's not even a new phenomena either. We've been working with this company for several years and over 40,000 people have already taken part in this opportunity. So, who is it? What is it? It is the Lingoda Language Sprint. Lingoda are an online language learning platform who offer online language speaking classes. And I can guarantee that this sprint is one of the best ways to find that speaking confidence we all strive to obtain when learning a foreign language. Why? Because of what they offer in their language sprint. So let me tell you about it. You can choose to do the sprint or the super sprint. The super sprint is 30 classes a month for 3 months. And if you attend all of them, you get 100% cash back. The sprint is 15 classes a month and you can still get 50% cash back. By the way, you can join the sprint in English, German, French, Spanish, and business English. When I was studying Spanish with them, I was amazed at how small the online classes were with a maximum of 5 students per class and with the 24/7 availability of classes. What's more is the teachers, they're not just random native blokes from Craigslist claiming all sorts. These guys, they know how to get the job done. They've been trained well. And I made a great connection with the teachers I had, which made me excited for each upcoming class because it was fun. Not only was it fun, the curriculum was structured and interesting, and you can even choose what topics you want to talk about by booking the relevant classes. I also loved how you could prep for the lesson beforehand with the slides ready and available at any time. So you could pretend it's the first time you've looked at the lesson with all your peers in class, but secretly you've been poring over it for a couple of hours. Shh, no one needs to know. All right, enough of this amazing opportunity for now. I will tell you how you can join the Lingoda Language Sprint later on in the video and when it all kicks off. If you're super keen, then check it out in the description box below. Either way, enjoy this video conversation between myself, Charlie, and Lucy from English with Lucy. All right, the first one is, what was the last thing you ate, Lucy?
Not very exciting. Normally, I have the same breakfast every single day, which is banana porridge. Oats, milk, banana. Porridge. It's so underrated, but I didn't have time to cook it today because I had to set up for our little podcast episode that we also recorded. So I just had the banana. I did also consider having a handful of raw oats and milk as well, so that inside it would be like the porridge, but I didn't do that.
You didn't do that, okay.
No.
That's a shame. No, that's wise. But thank you for sacrificing your oats for me this morning. What did you do last night, Lucy?
We had venison burgers.
Okay.
And we watched a couple of episodes of The Crown, which is a British TV programme on Netflix about the royal family.
Yeah, I've heard good things about this.
Yes, I'd never watched it before, but my brother recommended it to me, and we have very similar taste, and I did really enjoy it.
Okay, interesting. How old is your brother?
He was born in 1999, so he must be 21.
Right.
He's grown up so quickly. In my head, he's still 15.
Is that a typical evening for you, to have a nice dinner, like a proper dinner, and watch a nice little programme on Netflix?
Because Will's job, he's a farmer, is very, very active. He needs a proper dinner when he comes in from work. I don't, but I like to have a proper dinner anyway. So I always do. We have a light lunch and a proper dinner. We don't watch that much TV normally. But since it's been lockdown, we've definitely watched more.
Right, okay.
I like documentaries and things like that. I find it quite hard to get into series, but because there's an element of truth to the crown, I found it very interesting.
All right, the next question is a little bit silly. When was the last time you Googled yourself, Lucy?
Oh, when did I Google myself? I Googled my pronunciation course to see if it would come up in Google, and it didn't. I think it's too new at the moment. So that's probably the last time I Googled anything to do with myself. But I try not to Google myself too much. Oh, do you know what? Actually, we did a pub quiz and someone else had Googled me and had made a round on like silly comments that I'd had on my YouTube channel or articles with blatant lies in them. And I definitely did have a look afterwards to think, oh my word, what is there that people can find out? And there were some estimated net worths that were hilarious. Tens of millions, which is just not true.
That's nothing compared.
Yeah, there are some quite funny things on there. Nothing compared, sorry, I just got that. No.
Okay, so not too much Googling. Who was the last person you text, Lucy?
Oh, really boring. My manager, just to say, I can't speak. I'm recording with Charlie.
Brilliant.
But it was actually my mother, like the personal text I sent. I sent her a message about I'm taking my family to the Cotswolds at Christmas, and she had texted me all excited saying, do you think we should book pubs and, you know, dinners now? I think it could be a little early and we are in lockdown, so probably not. Yeah,
that's a lovely place to go though for Christmas. Quintessentially British.
Oh, we love it. Well, we're going after Christmas.
Oh, okay.
But yes, we have a post-Christmas relaxation, because Christmas isn't always that relaxing when you've got kind of lots of family. So we like to get away.
Yeah, I won't delve deeper with that one. Okay, so what's the last personal photo on your phone?
Oh, let's have a look. Oh, it's this one. Of my cat. This is Alfonso.
Yes, I noticed that Alfonso has a little bit of an extra bit on his ear.
Yes, tufts.
Yeah,
I don't know if
tufts,
you can see them. Yeah. He is a Maine Coon cat. So he's got certain characteristics, like the tufts on his ears and a very full chest, like a mane, a lion's mane. and he's a big boy. He is 4 kilos already, which is a lot.
So yeah, that's your latest personal photo.
Yeah.
What was the last book you read?
Oh, I read one on holiday. You know what? I don't read a lot of books. I listen to them on Audible. I absolutely love, because I do a lot of running. It's like two birds with one stone, isn't it? You listen as you go along. But the last one I actually read, which was the first book I'd physically read in a long time, was Lucky You by Dawn Porter, or Dawn O'Porter. And it was kind of a chick flick about three separate women who all seem to have the perfect life, but they don't really. And one of them was an influencer, and I found that quite interesting.
I love Audible too. I love, as you said, killing two birds with one stone. What was the last Audible book that you listened to?
I listened to one called Outraged, which was by a great... She's called Dottie, who wrote it and read it. She's used to be a DJ. No, it was about people becoming outraged at everything online, and lots of examples of that, and how people immediately jump to being really angry about something when actually there's a story behind it. Now, I found that really interesting in the age of cancel culture. And one I read before that, or listened to, was one called Unnatural Causes, which if you haven't listened to it, you absolutely have to. It's by a forensic pathologist.
Ooh, there's a mouthful.
Yes, forensic pathologist. And he looks at crime scenes and tries to work out what's happened to these dead bodies. And he did Princess Diana after the car crash.
Any gossip?
Lots, but you have to read it. You have to read it.
Okay, fair enough. What's the title of it again?
Unnatural Causes. It's so good.
Unnatural Causes. Okay, fair enough. So the next one, this is interesting.
Oh no.
if you hadn't met Will, right, would you ever consider dating a fan of yours?
I mean, I don't see why not. It's so hard to think of myself not being with Will.
Yes. But
definitely. But I would be worried that fan would have an image of what I might be like because they've only seen my videos. But maybe if I had started vlogging and they had seen what I was really like, then maybe I'd feel a bit more confident about that. It's just like a parallel universe, but I don't really have any... negative feelings about dating anyone, really.
Open to anything.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to miss out on like the perfect person, so why wouldn't I date a fan?
Yeah.
But unfortunately, or fortunately, I am with Will, so this is not an option.
Very fortunate. Okay, so this is bringing Will back in the picture.
Okay.
What do you think is your worst habit versus what Will thinks is your worst habit?
Oh. My worst habit. I've got so many. One very innocent habit that I've got that I know really annoys Will is I'll cook him something. I'll be really excited to hear his feedback. And he'll literally take a spoonful of it, put it near his mouth, and I'll say, "How is it? How would you rate it out of 10? And he's like, "I haven't put it in my mouth yet, Lucy." I'll stop doing that action. "I haven't put it in my mouth yet, Lucy. How can I give you feedback on it?" And I do it every time. I can't help it. I'm just so excited to hear what he thinks of my culinary creation. A more severe kind of annoying habit is that I'm very messy when it comes to my personal life. Work life is all very organised.
No, Lucy. Are you not tidy?
No, I really, really struggle with being tidy. When I take off my clothes, I'm the first... I do want to put it on the floor, but I am stopping myself and folding it and putting it away. But I am on top of it, but only, if I let it slide for one day, then I'm completely behind. And Will's very untidy.
Sorry, Will is very untidy.
Yeah, so together we're a nightmare.
No, you've got to have a balance.
No. So what did you say? Is your girlfriend untidy then?
She's the untidy one, but I'm a bit of a neat freak. Yeah.
I can see with that stack of books.
Yes, exactly.
Like, place them all perfectly.
Oh, it's beautiful. So perfectly placed. Not an inch of dust anywhere. A spot of dust, more like.
An inch? I'd be very worried.
I know. Yeah, an inch. Come on. No, Stacey, she puts her shoes out everywhere. And we've got a new game, actually, which is quite good. Maybe you might want to try this. If you leave something out, the other person can put it wherever they want. So I put her shoes under the sofa in an awkward position. And now she's starting to put her shoes away. But the annoying thing is, I'm sometimes forgetful when I leave mine out and mine end up under the sofa.
So it's like negative reinforcement then, the opposite of how you should train a dog.
Exactly.
That's horrendous. We've started the cat, when he gets up on surfaces, we were advised to spritz him with a little misting bottle. I've got one here. It's very, it's not inhumane. It's only a little psst.
Yeah, just a bit of alcohol.
Don't know why I've done that. No, absolutely not. I think I might do that to Will when he leaves his stuff around. Just go out to him and go, psst. We could start doing that to each other.
Yeah, I was going to say, he would have to do it to you because you're a messy girl.
Obviously, but I spent so long putting these curls in my hair that I would be so upset. So maybe that would really work if he started misting my hairstyles out of my hair every time I did something wrong.
Here we go. We're either going to get a very tidy house or a very wet couple. Sorry. Okay, so moving on. What is the first thing that you do when you wake up?
When I wake up, so Will nearly always gets up before me because he's normally got something to do on the farm quite early. I am brought a cup of coffee by Will. So Will brings me a cup of coffee in bed. And it all depends, my morning depends on whether he leaves the door open after he's brought that coffee or whether he leaves it shut. If he leaves it shut, I have the coffee in peace and I just start my day reading the news and sipping the coffee. If he leaves it open, the cat comes in and then I drink my coffee whilst the cat is getting under the duvet, attacking my feet, climbing the curtain, getting on the windowsill, chasing a fly. The other day, Will was holding this cup of coffee over the bed for me to have and the cat, no kidding, ran up, jumped in the air and slammed it with his paw and it just went everywhere. He was like slam dunking a basketball.
Wow.
So yes, it all depends on whether that door is open or shut.
A mischievous one. How, he's young though, isn't he?
He's 6 months, so he's a teenager at the moment. And he's starting to test boundaries.
Yeah, good phrase, test boundaries, yeah. Pushing his luck would be a synonymous phrase, maybe.
Definitely.
Hello, it's moustacheless Charlie, back to give you the lowdown on how and when to join the Lingoda Language Sprint. It starts on April 28th, 2021, and you can sign up until April 16th. Both the Sprint and the Super Sprint require a €49 deposit that is also included in the cashback reward if you attend your classes. The payments you need to make are in 3 installments, so it's not one big amount you need to pay to start the language sprint. And the rules are simple. Attend your classes, get your cashback reward. But as always, please check all the rules carefully before signing up. And I also want to mention how if something happens and you can't attend all your lessons and get the cashback reward, they are incredibly affordable at around €10 each, which for a small group class with a trained native teacher, is brilliant. And what I have also felt passionate about in regards to this concept that Lingoda have designed is the urgency that the sprint offers. Right from the start, your motivation is through the roof due to the monetary reward. Then throughout the process, the real reward of speaking confidence takes over. And because you're doing it every day, it's possible to actually see the change in your skills even if you're at that intermediate plateau. And then you'll realize it's not about getting the money back, it's about continuing this winning streak of progress with your language skills, which very cleverly turns this kind of fear-based motivation of losing money and what they call an away from goal into a towards goal, meaning gaining something such as fluency in a foreign language. And this constant positive reinforcement every day for 3 months can genuinely create a lasting habit of a successful language learning daily routine that can obviously go far beyond the 3 month sprint. And the final brilliant thing I want to mention is that, as I said, if for some reason you miss some classes, the motivation, it's still there to make every class worth it. So even if you lost, you'd still be the winner because what you're here for, what you're tuning into this video for, I imagine, is to improve your language skills. And that is without question achieved with any decent speaking class that you do every day. So the Lingo de Language Sprint, in my opinion, is simply one of the best options out there in this current market. And I love telling you guys about it because I really believe in it. I believe it gives you motivation that nowhere else can give. In the past, I've seen some people miss out due to limited spaces. So if you're keen, don't wait until April 16th. Act now, secure your space and, you know, limber up for the start of a new you on the 28th of April, 2021. Again, the link is in the description box below. I will tell you how to get a discount on the deposit towards the end of this video. Good luck if you decide to join the sprint, but let's get back to the video. So the next one, you said that you are watching The Crown, but is there any other series or films that you've watched recently that you like and you would tell your friends about?
Yes, another series, also on Netflix, not sponsored, wish we were, was The Queen's Gambit. Have you heard of this?
I have, and I've actually started listening to the Audible version of it.
Have you? Oh, I might do that as well. What a great idea. Okay, well, I'm sure you know what it's about then, but I'll let you know again.
I do, but tell the audience, you know.
It's about an orphan girl. Orphan means that you've got no parents, they've passed away, who discovers that she's very good at chess and she works her way up to becoming very, very successful. I'm not going to ruin anything. But she also deals with addiction while she's doing it, because when she was living in the orphanage, a home for children with no parents, they provide tranquilizers. And obviously, if you take a drug from a young age, you're very likely to have addiction issues. So that's...
That makes sense, because I fall asleep listening to Audible.
Ah.
And they were saying about this pill. No, it's fine. And they were talking about this pill, and I just didn't understand why they were having this pill. Oh, so they're being drugged.
Yeah, I think it's just to keep them calm. I think there was there were huge prescription medication problems in the late 50s and 60s in America, and I think tranquilizers were part of it.
Wow, there we go. Okay, so The Queen's Gambit.
The Queen's Gambit is fantastic, and the lead actress is just amazing. She's so cool.
I will obviously be missing that on Audible, so I'll get onto Netflix for that. Okay, moving on to romantic question.
Not that romantic question.
What's a romantic gesture that you would appreciate, Lucy? Apart from me asking you out.
A romantic gesture that I would appreciate... I'm trying to think of what has already been done.
Well, I feel like a coffee in the morning is a romantic gesture in some way.
It's about consistency, isn't it? Committing.
This is for life, love.
Yeah, I'm just taking the romance out of it. What I find really romantic is consistency.
Certainly not spontaneous.
That no.
It's very, very far from, isn't it?
I think it's also when someone really listens to you, remembers something, and then at a later date performs on it. So, for example, when I first met Will, I told him I really love fruit. You know, fruit. And ever since I was a kid, fruit. I mean, I used to have... My mum used to approach...
Are you saying fruit? As in the vegetable. Fruit, as in fruit and vegetables.
Yeah, fruit.
Right, okay, carry on.
Why, what did you expect?
No, just, I'm just shocked. Carry on.
Okay, Lucy. Maybe it's because I was using a glottal stop at the end, fruit.
it's fruit. You okay. Love fruit.
I love fruit. I mean, where are my earrings? Anyway, I've got so many fruit earrings. Today I've got the Corona bottles because we are in lockdown once again. My mum used to approach me with a bowl of fruit when I was a child, and I used to physically shake with excitement. I used to be allowed to pick sweets at the supermarket, and I would approach my mum with a packet of lychee or something like, "Mum, can I have these?"
Oh, right. So, yeah, you've had no problem getting the five a day.
No, I actually got told I was eating too much sugar because I was eating so much fruit and had to switch to more vegetables, which was depressing. But yeah, so I told Will that I really loved fruit, and the following Easter, he didn't get me any Easter eggs. He just got me lots of round egg-shaped fruits instead of Easter eggs. So I had a watermelon.
Wow, that's a big one.
Lots of kiwis and
okay, and yeah, things kiwis, like that. That's yeah. a good one.
And a yeah. mango as well. And I just thought,
a mango.
There's a man that listens. I like that.
That is good, yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe a lime is good.
A lime? No, I'm not going to have a... You can't bite into a lime.
Oh, so you've got to be able to bite... What? Hang on. What were the others?
You watermelon.
You can't bite into a... Well, you need to chop that up.
No, the best way, cut it in half, eat it like a bowl of cereal. Just scoop it out.
Oh, I thought you were going to use your face. Okay.
Yeah, all right. No, I'm not going to use my face.
Okay, romantic gesture. Get Lucy a bowl of fruit. She'll love it.
Yeah.
Okay. What are some values? Oh, this is quite deep, actually. But Stacey and I stumbled across this question, and I bloody love it. So you might need a bit of time,
okay.
but we'll see. What are some values you'd like your child to grow up to have? And before I go on to tell you how you can get your hands on the rest of this conversation, I'd like to remind you of the amazing opportunity available for those who act soon and secure their place for the Lingoda Language Sprint. It's been running for more than 3 years, and the concept is proven by many successful students all over the world. So if you want to make a real difference to your language abilities, then sign up now with our code CHANGE59 and get €10 discount off your deposit. Right, so there we go. Over 20 minutes listening practice with the one and only Lucy from English with Lucy. And this conversation continues to have me in fits of laughter whilst I was editing it. And you can get the video or audio of both parts 2 and 3 over on the BritishEnglishPodcast.com. If you don't know by now, I run an online academy over there now with a ton of digital learning resources for intermediate to advanced learners. The episode I released of this conversation has 2 extra parts, so it's a 3-parter with manually edited transcripts, extended glossaries, and over, I think, 65 native expressions explained and flashcards to help you revise on the go. And then I also have lessons attached to other episodes with videos explaining vocabulary in detail, pronunciation drilling, assignments, quizzes, you name it. You can find all of that by clicking up here or in the description box below, or simply go to thebritishenglishpodcast.com. Stick around here, though, for a bit longer as I went on to ask Lucy about the thing that she has been slaving over for the last 6 months to a year, and it's all for English learners like yourself. Tell me all about your pronunciation course that I spotted the other day.
Oh, yes. I have written a course. It's my first ever course. It's a British English pronunciation course where I teach modern RP. That's the accent that I speak with. And it's basically a course that will teach you to speak confidently and naturally.
Okay.
So we go through every phoneme, every sound that comprises modern received pronunciation. We look at connected speech, rhythm and stress, intonation, other little extra bits like the glottal stop and how to pronounce ED at the end of words, the dark L,
amazing,
the linking R. We go through absolutely everything. There's over 6 hours of lessons and over 49 individual lessons.
Wow.
It was a big job to create, but I am so proud of it. I got 2 linguists to check through everything as well. One checked through all the scripts before I filmed, another one went through afterwards. So I feel very, very confident about what I've created, and we've had lots of students take it already, and the feedback has been amazing.
Oh, amazing.
It's been a huge project. But I'm so happy with the results. And I've actually created a little discount code for your viewers.
Wonderful.
If they would like to have a look at it.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
It's BEP15, and that gives you 15% off the full course.
Okay, fantastic.
So they can go to Epiphany Language Studios. That's the name of the language platform I've created.
Okay.
The British English Pronunciation Course, BEP15. 15 for 15% off.
Wonderful. All right, fantastic. So we will put that in the show notes of the podcast and the description box of YouTube. So yeah, thank you very much, Lucy. I appreciate your time.
Thank you.
And yeah, an interesting insight into the personality behind the channel.
Thank you for having me. It has been a pleasure. Very enjoyable morning for me. Evening for you, I hope.
Yeah, it has been. Yeah. Well, on that note, that's all from me. Thank you, Lucy. Goodbye.
Thank you for having me.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
I think I throw you off.
I'm going to keep that.